also help you navigate through your goals with much more ease, strong anchors to hold it down. Hi friends, my name is Ashwini. I welcome you all today to my channel. Every year end we say that this is something that I'm going to start doing from Jan 1st or this is my New Year's resolution. But instead of just vaguely deciding our goals, how about we see how much progress we have done this year, and then if there are certain things on which we have fallen off the wagon, try and pick up from there, or if there are certain things in which we have achieved great success, try and build up on that success. I always start with a list of good things that I got to enjoy this year. So it can be just 2-3 points, some major things that I did and really made me happy, or some major milestones that I've achieved. Or it can be as exhaustive as possible with every single thing that you got to enjoy this year. One tip here is to scroll through your Instagram feed or maybe through your camera roll or your photos album and find out all those nice pics which you captured maybe during some festivals, maybe when you're having a good time with your friends and families. This obviously is kind of an inventory for all the good things and helps you feel that feeling of gratitude. But at the same time, it helps you relive those moments, and this will put you in a mindset of abundance and happiness. So psychologically, it is now a positive frame of mind with which you can start planning the next year. Instead of, you know, just thinking about, oh, I had to do so many things and these were my goals and I could not achieve it. So instead of having this mindset, we now have a mindset of positive, happy moments and grateful moments, which will help us to get into the correct way of thinking to revise the year, which is my next step. For the revision of the year, I always write down one or two important things that happened in each month of the year. So the easiest way to do is just list down the months on a piece of paper or on your phone and write down one or two, three experiences that you had, lessons you may have learned, some travels that you might have done, some emotional moments that have happened, or maybe some milestones that you have reached. So in each month, I at least have one or two things that have helped me experience this life in a much better way. There might be some emotional experiences also, but then as we always say that every experience is to be lived and learned from. So that is what I write down. If there is absolutely nothing that has happened amazing in that month, so I just write down one or two books that I have read in that month which were very nice. And by doing this step, at the end, when you complete this, it's like hardly 5 minutes. If you're maintaining a monthly journal, this is even more easy and it will happen just like a breeze. But nevertheless, the way I mentioned will also be equally quick. If you do this exercise, by the end of it, each month, even if you have written down only one single thing, you will have 12 different things that you have either learned, experienced, or enjoyed. Yes. Next step is actually decluttering. Decluttering is very essential when you're going for goal setting. Now you'll be like, Ashwini, are we doing goal setting or are we cleaning our wardrobe? But think about it. If your wardrobe is filled up with all the clutter and all the clothes that might not fit you or that are too old, do you think you can make room for new stuff? Of course not, right? You have to first declutter all those things and make space for new stuff that actually bring you happiness, that actually fit you, and that actually make you feel very happy. Similarly, for the goals, instead of just piling on new goals on whatever is existing you have set as a goal, maybe this year or 4 years or 3 years ago, just declutter all those goals which are not going to add any value, or as of now do not have any importance in your life, or are not really of high priority, I would say. Think of those goals that are actually going to add value and make you progress in your life step by step. And in order to make room for those goals, it is very essential that you declutter your goals list from the last year and find out some goals that are not relevant for you and just let them go, because this is not the right time for those goals to serve you. Before you set your new goals after decluttering your old ones, it is very important that you also take care of your well-being. See, so for like me, life is not just about setting goals, achieving them. What if the entire journey was miserable and I was miserable in that journey, and if I did not enjoy any of it? So for that, yes, there needs to be some direction for your ship in the ocean of life, but at the same time, there needs to be strong anchors to hold it down at a place to understand what has happened throughout the journey and how you can make the next journey of your life better. For me, these anchors are health, wealth, relationship, and my professional career. So taking an example of health, if I ran a 5K marathon last December, am I able to run for a 10K marathon this year? Or maybe run the same 5K marathon in a lesser time? Or was I very mindful about the way I eat during the entire year? Or how was my health during the entire year? Was I active? Was I ill? Or what was it? So basically, these are not some numbers that you can measure on a scale, but it is just a graph that you can see that has happened over the last year to this year. Same goes for finances. If I was bad at saving, am I better at it now? Or if I've already improved the habit of saving, am I able to invest more now? If I'm investing nicely and if I know all the things, have I built enough assets for my future? So these are, again, as I said, certain things you can measure, but certain things you can't measure. But the graph for that is very much visible, and you know at after this journey, this is the anchor that has held me down at this point of time. And from here, what do I need to do to make the journey of finances better? In my relationship anchor, maybe I would think of, have I become more supportive? Have I become more understanding? Is there a more maturity level for me in each of my relationships that I have with my friends and families? You can always use the help of a spouse or a friend or a family member to give you a feedback about how you are actually in the relationship with them. And really, don't worry if they give you a negative feedback. They do it out of love, and if they are giving you a negative feedback, consider this as an input to improve upon the next year. My professional career, this generally doesn't take me too long because I've been blessed to be working in an organization where we have monthly connects with our leaders and they give us a feedback or support on how we need to improve in our career. But apart from this, I will always take an inventory of, are there any new skills apart from my job that I have developed this year? Have I put them to use? And are there any good books that I have read on the subject of leadership, of marketing, or anything that might help me in my professional career? See, now these are my anchors. Your anchors may be totally different, and that is totally fine. But make sure that you reflect on these anchors at the end of every year, so they help you align yourself and your life and your vision with the bigger picture of your life. They will also help you navigate through your goals with much more ease, and also to make sure that you are enjoying the journey towards achieving those goals. Once you have this reflection for the year in place, it can now help you to serve as a roadmap to build on your goals for the next year or the coming years. So this is a much better and a mindful way of deciding what you want to actually do with your life the coming years, rather than just saying that, oh, I will join the gym from the 1st of Jan, or I would want to read more. By the way, if you really want to read more and you are struggling with your busy schedule, comment down below in this video and I will help you with another video on how to read better and how to read faster when you are short of time. And there will be a second part to this video in which you can use this information and now start building on your new goals, which is coming very soon. So make sure that you hit the subscribe button as well as the notification bell so you do not miss that video. I hope this video helped you, and if it did, make sure to give it a like, share, subscribe, all that good stuff. And I will see you in the next video. You take care till then. Bye-bye.